Willimantic Fire, Connecticut. Firefighters battle fire at waste paper company in Willimantic, Connecticut. Willimantic Con, firefighters are battling a large blaze at a waste and recycling company. In Willimantic, Connecticut, CBS affiliate WFSB reports. Fire officials said 12 departments responded to the scene at the Willimantic Waste Paper Company on West Main Street in Willimantic, about 30 miles east of Hartford. Several roads in the area have been closed to traffic, and photos from local television stations showed flames and smoke billowing from the plant Sunday morning. There were no immediate reports of injuries. WFSB reports there have been no evacuations, but officials are recommending people stay inside their homes. The family-owned company provides trash pickup and recycling services in eastern Connecticut and has been in business for more than 60 years, according to its website. Windham spokesperson Matt Vertefeuille told WFSB that firefighters cannot enter the building because its roof has collapsed. Fire officials said the building is a steel structure and the fire could last for days. Hundreds of firefighters battle blaze at Willimantic Waste Facility. Fire expected to burn overnight. Hundreds of firefighters spent hours Sunday battling a three-alarm blaze that broke out in the morning at a Willimantic waste processing plant, igniting a 50-ton stockpile of wood and plaster and construction debris. Officials said late Sunday that firefighters will continue battling the fire overnight and that town schools will be closed Monday. The fire started around 10:13 a.m. at Willimantic Waste Paper Co., a family-owned business that collects and processes garbage, recyclables and construction debris in Holland, Hartford, Middlesex, Windham and New London counties, according to the company's website. Officials said nearly 12 fire departments have assisted with the fire, as are local agencies like the Windham Police Department and the State Department of Energy and Environmental Protection. Officials said they do not believe anyone was in the building when the fire broke out, but two people, including one firefighter, were transported to Windham Hospital and assessed for exhaustion and lightheadedness. 20,180,128 willow waste. Fire officials work a fire Sunday at a Willimantic Waste Paper Co. Inc. building adjacent to General Cable. Mark Murko, Hartford Current. Windham Town Manager Jim Rivers said the decision to close school was due to road closures and lingering smoke. Rivers said earlier Sunday that officials were setting up for a long-term operation. Late Sunday, he said staff was also preparing to set up the town's emergency operations center and possibly move people, specifically elderly, around the city. Rivers said officials have not decided on that yet, but it is something they want to be prepared for. Eastern Connecticut State University posted online late Sunday that it would be closed Monday as a precaution. Students on campus are encouraged to go home, but those who must remain on campus can stay at the Betty R. Tipton Room or the Student Center Cafe relief stations. Windham Hospital officials released a statement late Sunday night saying that the hospital would continue to operate as usual. DEEP has determined there are no toxic chemicals present in the air at the hospital and there is no danger to patients or staff. Hartford Healthcare spokesperson Steve Coates said in an email. About 9:30 p.m. Sunday, Windham Fire Chief Mark Scrivener said operations have been scaled back due to safety concerns, but firefighters continue to operate three tower ladders and other heavy equipment to pull debris from the building. We are still putting water on the fire. We are still actively attempting to extinguish it. Scrivener said, we expect the fire to burn for the foreseeable future. Scrivener said the way the building is constructed caused some issues for firefighters. But the most significant issue the hundreds of firefighters have dealt with is smoke. The facility's steel roof collapsed, meaning firefighters started attacking the flames from outside the building. He said the 100,000 square foot building was considered a total loss and that firefighters were working to keep fire away from the building's office so records could be maintained. West Main Street will remain closed, and businesses in the area will probably be closed Monday morning, Matt Vertefeuille, Windham's director of code enforcement, said. Police said portions of Route 66 and 32, which were shut down Sunday, may remain closed into Monday morning. Earlier Sunday, NBC Connecticut meteorologist Ryan Hanrahan reported that the black smoke that plumed into the sky had registered on the local TV station's weather radar. Vertefeuille said the waste plant was up to code, had a working sprinkler system and had been regularly inspected by city officials. Area residents were urged by officials to conserve water and those living downwind from the fire were told to stay indoors to avoid breathing in the smoke. Though the fire's cause is being investigated by state fire marshals and remains uncertain, it was clear that the large waste processing facility would not survive the inferno. The building will have to come down, Vertefeuille said. Willimantic Waste, now in its third generation of DeVivo family ownership, employs more than 160 people and operates three waste and recycling plants. According to the company's website, Deep Emergency Supervisor Jeff Chandler said that testing was done to check for air toxicity. He said so far that testing has come back as non-detect but urges residents to stay inside and out of the smoke plume. He said his team has concluded that there was no asbestos in the building. Ongoing testing of water runoff by a deep mobile lab team was still underway Sunday evening. But Chandler said there is no visible oil sheen at the Willimantic River, though the surface water is greatly discolored. He said he has contacted DEEP's Fisheries Division and a representative is planning to visit the Willimantic River area Monday morning to look at impacts to wildlife. Though the facility held relatively little garbage because the company was installing a new waste processing machine, it contained about 50 tons of wood and plaster debris, Chandler said. Some Willimantic residents who live near the burning building reported that brown water was coming out of taps. Chandler said this was because fire crews had plumbed the city's water reserves, stirring sediments that normally lie undisturbed at the bottom of tanks and pipes, and that the discoloration was not dangerous to people's health. CNN. Like. Share. Subscribe. CNN. Like. Share. Subscribe.